Mama Ziggs is here. Cindy is here cheering him on. And he has waited for this moment for a long time to get on the big stage and show everybody what he's about. And he'll have a chance to do that on defense first against our guy, Billy Weema.
So Weema will have the rock first. And if you miss the first game of the day, he loves ball control, but he also, you can't sleep on him, because the next thing you know, he'll be throwing a home run to the crib. First and 10, McFadden bounces off his wad.
Get on it!
And the Arkansas Razorback, the former Razorback, to the crib. And Ziggs is like, by the way, Ziggs, welcome to the stream.
Have you met Darren McFadden yet?
You wanted to be on the stream, you're on the stream, and you're down 7-0 to the local man, Billy Weema.
And he was laughing that off, and I don't know what type of laugh was that. Was that a laugh of like, okay, I'll be able to overcome this, or is that a very frustrated laugh? We'll see how he responds right here. We talked about it at the top of the cast. I think that Darren McFadden is going to skyrocket in the meta after people see Weema use him. His stats are very good. He can run. He can catch. He's fast. He's a big back. Very good running back in Madden Ultimate Team.
Yeah, that's the 92 elite. Just 51 salary cap. So a great value. And now Ziggs has got to go back to work. Reese picks up 10. I think it's going to be second and inches.
I'm interested. Let's watch what Ziggy can do on offense here. I like that focus, you see. That's a real focused look. I'm very interested to see how he moves the ball on offense right now. You see a little bit of the gun doubles action. Very balanced formation.
Goes back to the run. Worked the first time. And he gets
it's out. You owe me brisket. That was Reese.
He fumbled it, but he didn't turn it over.
We said fumble. He's going to cough it up.
All right.
Brisket, well done.
Brisket challenge. You got it. It's happening. Before we leave KC. And the pass to Rice. Not able to hold on. And there's Mel Blount with another big hit.
Yeah, throwing into some traffic right there. They got the ball into the receiver's hands, but when there's defenders around you, they can kind of scrape in there and, you know, poke the ball out a little bit. And that's what we saw right there.
So quick to claim the brisket.
You seen how
instantly brisket.
I love messing around when it comes to my brisket bet.
It's Reese in the flat for three, so it'll be 3rd and 7. Let's see what Ziggs does, trailing by a touchdown.
7.
He pretty much, Ziggs pretty much told us he was going to win this tournament.
He guaranteed it. And he said not only is he going to win this tournament, he said you're going to, can he win that tackle battle? No. Got himself in a forced down. He not only said he's going to win this tournament, he said I'm going to win the whole thing, and you're going to be seeing a lot of me going forward. I'm telling you, the kid was reeking of confidence, and I loved it. That's as a young buck coming into the game.
I didn't believe in yourself. I didn't feel it was arrogance. Like, it wasn't arrogance.
It was pure confidence.
Yeah.
He feels he is the best. He feels he's put in a lot of work, and he's earned the right to say those things. And there's nothing wrong with it. And I fully respect someone that believes in themselves, that's put in the work to do so. And no!
He had Cooper wide open. When he clicked on, he headed upfield. Instead of flattening out and coming to the ball, and that's a turnover on downs.
And he's dealing with adversity early. Had what should have been a touchdown, instead turns into a turnover on downs. Gave up a first play touchdown on your run. So this young buck is going to see early in how he can deal with adversity. And if you expect to be in this for the long haul and make runs in all these tournaments, you better be world class at dealing with adversity, because it is going to pop up. It is a guarantee.
Back to McFadden, who had a long run the
again,
first time.
Again.
And here he goes.
This is on his horse. Two for two TDs. Billy Weema representing KC and defending his home turf. He's got Ziggs back all the way against the wall, and we're only in the first quarter.
Head to the auction house, get yourself a McFadden, because two carries, and he takes it to the crib both times, and he's leading by 14. Welcome to Kansas City, Ocean Gang.
Let's see how Ziggy can respond right now. He's going to have to do something. And the thing that stinks being down 14-0 is even if you get down there, you need to get seven or taking three. It's still a two-possession ball game. He's really dug himself in a hole right here, but he can begin to get himself out of it if he's able to put together a strong drive. Count it off the tip. He's on his horse, Cooper, and take a little bit of luck, Ziggs, because you might need it, but he's back.
Amari Cooper with a touchdown. And the circus has come to town early.
And that, we talk about it, that's why you have to fight through adversity, Scott, because breaks go both ways. Just because it looks like things aren't going your way doesn't mean they won't start to go your way later in the game. And that was a great example of that. Usually receivers don't catch the ball off the tip. You have to get very lucky for that to happen. And that's what happened to Ziggs right there. So he should feel very fortunate. He's got a ton of momentum back. Let's see if he can stop this prolific run game of Billy Weema.
So Weema still leading by a touchdown after the circus catch off the tip by Amari Cooper.
Are you going to be able to handle this game? Are we going to need to get some oxygen in down here?
Oh, my gosh. I'm already breathing heavy. I'm excited. There's big plays. Yeah. Big plays happen. I get excited. Tail stops wagging. I can't help myself.
Well, McFadden just went for a gain of zero. He's got three carries for 130 yards.
Weema does run the ball 51% of the time when he was qualifying for this ladder. No other competitor here ran more than 41%. So he definitely is the most committed to the run game out of all our competitors.
Quick throw to McFadden, gets him on the edge, gets a block from Fuller, and he's out to the 50-yard line. Shout out to Donnie Moore for the stats. The commish.
Commish Don.
Commish Don.
The legend, the Raiders Caesar. The systems designer.
Does it all.
Guy's resume is beast.
Thought I wore a lot of hats. First and 10 from the 50. Got a great crew here in Kansas City. Folks back at home, a lot of familiar faces in the chat, and thanks for hanging with us. There's some great Madden football today. And McFadden carries a few defenders to the 46.
We were talking, personally was talking a little bit of trash earlier about Weema's run stick. I thought he made some questionable cuts, but it looks like he's cleaned that up a little bit.
So. Did he go back and watch the broadcast?
I don't know if he heard me or whatnot, but he's making me eat my words right now thus far.
We were throwing all different types of shade his way in the first game. Launch to the right, quick throw to Cooks. And he's up underneath to the 38. First pass of the game for Mariota, and it goes for a first down.
I just love his offense. He has so many weapons. When you got the Cooks, who has world-class speed, you got Fuller, who is one of the fastest players in the game. McFadden, we already talked about him. He could do it all. Mariota has the arm and the mobility. And then you have Larry Fitzgerald, who can go up and get a high point ball if you need it. I've been so impressed with Billy Weema's roster. It's not even funny. And I told Chow as soon as I saw it, said if this kid can get by Warhawk, he's going to make a run. This roster is nasty, and personnel is a big thing. GMing is a skills. You need to be good at the game, Scott, but you also need to be able to build your team correctly, and I feel like Weema has done the best job of that out of anybody thus far.
There's the wide receiver quick out of the single back formation, goes for six. He basically told us that he's going to get 2 to 3 yards on that guaranteed.
Yeah, you need to. If you're his opponent, you need to have the scouting report on that. If you see that Cooks going in motion, you need to show me that you could do something else besides hand it to him when he goes in motion. I would key completely in on that and make sure I took it away.
Well, he needs 2 yards here. He's got to string it out, and he picks up three and moves the chains.
If you saw that last play, Ziggy's user defender was on the right side of the offensive line. When he comes in motion, you know he's motioning, running to the left. You need to be more aggressive on getting over there, setting the edge, and committing to that Cooks run.
Well, here's the problem. So you send a guy in motion, and then thing you know, McFadden's going up the gut. Here we go.
And that's fine. You have to show me that.
Yeah.
You have to show me that. Before I'm going to commit to stopping that, I need to see it. And that's a good play call by Weema, because probably as soon as Ziggs is thinking to himself, all right, I'm sick of Cooks. I'm going to lock in on it. I'm going to key in on it. he changes the pace a little bit and gives him something extra to think about. Loving Weema's play calling so far.
So we made it through the first 5 minutes. There's been some fireworks here in the semifinal number one, as really the two higher seeds move on. This is 8 versus 5. Ziggs is 5. Billy Weema's number 8 in this tournament.
Well, we felt that coming into this tournament. That seeding meant nothing.
Absolutely.
We said this is the closest the field's been all club series long, and we knew that this tournament was completely up for grabs, Scott, so I'm not surprised right now.
A little bit of a delay there on the lead draw. That's going to bring up 3rd and 6 from the 23. Leading by a touchdown is Billy Weema.
Yeah, right here, too, if you're Weema. You don't want to do anything too risky. If you don't get the first down, you're at least in field goal range and can make it 2 possessions. A turnover here would be detrimental to his chances to win this game. So he needs to stay safe, and I think he's going to. It looks like he wants to run the ball with McFadden. But that box is loaded up. I don't know if he's going to be able to get anything off of this. Yeah, no.
The answer is no.
That was a little too conservative. I know I said don't force anything or whatnot, but you could at least pass the ball.
That was rough.
Yeah,
was
you can pass it, run around, run with Mariota. If it's not there, throw the ball away. There's also a mechanic this year in Madden where if you hold down the left trigger and right trigger, you could just go and press the X button. Your quarterback will go down to avoid a sack, fumble, or anything like that. I would have liked to see Weema drop back and pass and kind of survey the field, keep it safe. But, you know, instead it looked like he was really happy to take his 3 right there.
Well, he's got a 10-point lead, and now Ziggs. It's time for him to go to work with 4:09 remaining in the half. And he sort of has survived the storm. Now can Ziggs go on the attack?
Yeah. And he had a chance earlier. One of those fourth down plays that he didn't get. Yeah, throw it away. One of those fourth down plays he didn't get, Scott. The guy was open. It was a touchdown. Just, you know, miscommunication. The quarterback overthrew him a little bit. And it wasn't perfect execution. But had he executed the play, he had a touchdown waiting. So he's fully capable of putting up points in a hurry. He just needs a couple of things to go his way, and he needs to tighten up on execution.
Checks it down to Reed, and Reed will look for the sticks. It might be just a bit short. Yeah, it looked like he had the ball on his left arm. And it's going to be 3rd and inches at the 34.
See if Weema has sneak D. A lot of times in these inches situations, players like to go to that QB sneak out of goal line. But when you're playing on this high of level, people usually have defense for it.
Can't get there in time. And Aaron Rodgers will pick up 1.5 yards. And more important, he picks up the first down. Yep. So 10th play of the game in the books. You can see he really likes the throw of the football.
Good read.
Finds Cooper, who stumbles to the 46. That'll be enough to move the chains.
A strong route combination right there by Ziggy. Yeah, he has the plays. You can tell this kid has the talent. He just needs to get it. He needs a couple things to go his way. He needs to tighten up, and he can really start to make something happen here.
Mari Cooper in motion. 2 to the left, 1 to the right. Rodgers gets rid of it, throws it to coverage, and it's picked off by Anthony Barr. And watch out here, RG, because he can move. And he's got a reservation for 6.
Ziggy, Ziggy, Ziggy. He had the entire left side of the field wide open, Scott. I was literally looking at the left sideline like, which of these wide open 3 receivers does he want to throw to? And then he throws it to the right side of the field where there's triple cover. There was 3 defenders around the receiver and then a defender that came over to catch it off of the tip. That was a Stevie Wonder read is what we like to call that, Scott.
I thought you were about to break it down. I thought I was going to have Ziggy, Ziggy, Ziggy. Can't you see? Sometimes your throws just hypnotize me.
Freestyle. Freestyle Wednesday. With Scott Cole and RJ.
Now we're having fun. It's been a great atmosphere in Kansas City. They've been absolutely fantabulous hosts. And Billy Weema, their hometown hero, comes to the games. Comes to the games. He doesn't know what team was playing. I'm like, when's the last time you were here? It was 10 degrees. That's what he told me.
That's what he said.
Well, who are they playing?
Yeah, I have to know. He says he goes to a lot of Chiefs games. And you got to wonder, how much extra motivation is that when you know you're defending your home turf? You have people that are fans of other teams trying to come in here and take what's important to you. That's very motivating, Scott. And you got to think the crowd knows that he's the hometown hero, the Chiefs fan. He probably has all of them behind him right now, and he is just using that momentum to all the potential that he needs. He's really making things happen.
And Aaron Rodgers catches one from Bud Dupree in the backfield. Loss of one on the sack. And here's the two-minute warning, and you're trailing by 17. I'm not saying you need to, you know, I'm not saying you need to call the Coast Guard, but you at least got to put your life jacket on because the flood is coming in.
It could be. It very well could be. But I've seen people come back from this situation plenty of times. It just takes a certain type of mental toughness, Scott. You need to have that mental toughness of not giving up and staying one play at a time and not trying to get it all back in one play. The problem is, at 20 years old with limited tournament experience, I don't know if Ziggy has that type of mental toughness.
Another big hit. Can't hold on. And so it'll be 4th and 11, and you got to go. I know you're on your own 35. Trailing by 17, possessions have now become very limited.
Yeah, Josh Ziegler, a.k.a. Oceangangzigs, what a huge play right here if he wants to keep his tournament hopes alive.
Got to get rid of it.
Make something happen, and that's not making something happen.
He did a thing, but not the right thing.
I think you were right. Maybe I should have got my raincoat.
I'm not prepared.
I'm not.
I got the Jordans on. I don't have the goulashes on.
I didn't dress for this weather. Whew.
1:34 to go. Boy, if Weema can push it in here, Ziggs is in some serious trouble. Coasted to the semifinal. I'm talking about Ziggs. 45-19. Weema battled to get to this point. And I'm going to be honest with you. That man right there, he's my Madden spirit animal. He's absolutely locked in.
Hey, did you just say that? You're such a savage, Scott.
Can I get him to sign a Chiefs hat for me or something? I need it.
I'm trying to keep a straight face there. You talking about Madden spirit animals. That was fantastic.
3rd and 13. And we talked about it. Last time he had it, he was content with running the ball and taking the field goal. That's only going to put him up 20 here if he decides to go that route. Looks like he's going to go the air, RG.
Yeah, he's going to get aggressive right here. And why not? You can get aggressive in these situations.
He'll just throw it away.
Yeah, when you're up this many points, when you're up 7-3 scores, now they call that in football, it's shot play time. Sometimes that's the best time to take a shot. The defense is sitting.
Snuck it in there.
The defense is sitting back, thinking that you're going to run the ball, trying to kill the clock, and that's usually when the field opens up. So nothing wrong with that right there by Weema. I'm actually okay with the play call. If he did run the ball, Zig still had a timeout where he would have been able to stop the clock anyways. So.
Well, you were at Super Bowl 51.
I was.
Stranger things have happened. It's a 20-point game, 49 seconds to go in the half. If you're Ziggs, you need it.
You need it. You need to channel your inner Tom Brady right now and get as clutch as you've ever been. You wanted a chance to get on the big stage and make a name for yourself. You come back from 20 points, come back and win. Fair to say you'll make a pretty good name for yourself.
That's the story that needs to be written by Ziggs. 2nd and 7, 30 seconds to go. Gives it to Jerry Rice, picks up the first down, and he'll burn his second timeout. One remaining, ball at the 34.
Moving down the field. Watch the twist.
Need some momentum. Even if it's three, just get you some momentum.
It's awkward because he doesn't have a lot of time and he only has the one timeout.
And almost picked off by a sliding Paul Krause. And I'll be honest with you, the heat that Weema's bringing in this tournament looks pretty good.
Yeah.
You're uncomfortable back there. It's not screaming, but you're uncomfortable.
The thing I like about it too, Scott, is usually people run the nickel normal type of defense. Weema's in a nickel 2-4-5. which has outside linebackers on the at the end positions instead of DN. That allows you to do a lot of different things with those guys, like man them up, move them around, that you can't do with the defensive ends. We may be seeing a meta shift with the Billy Weema defense. Do we switch from the nickel normal meta to the nickel 2-4-5 meta maybe?
Setting a precedence thus far, looking really good. We got 18 seconds left, no timeouts for Ziggs. Ball at the 47, Rodgers.
What a shed, what a block shed. Oh my goodness, Bud Dupree just got in there instantly, and the problem for Ziggs is he has an all Browns offensive line. He didn't spend any of his salary cap on his offensive line. He went as got him for as cheap as he possibly could, tanked them as much as possible, and that's what's going to allow things like those insta block sheds to happen. That's the risk you run.
One timeout remaining for Weema. And he's in a cover 100. There's a million guys back there.
Quarter street deep, man up three deep.
Throws it. And almost caught, but could not hang on. And we'll move to halftime, and it's been all Billy Weema.
All Billy Weema. I was a little discouraged to see Weema not click on right there and hold the SWAT button, though. He kind of just let the AI handle it, which, you know, in double coverage
could come into play.
Deal, but yeah, it could be risky. I mean, if you're a top player in the world, you want to get your user defender in there as much as possible. So interesting right there from Weema.
So 27-7, get Ziggs has the ball here to start the second half, trailing by 20.
If he could get a quick score, we've seen how fast fumbles happen, pick sixes happen. There's plenty of time.
So second and 8. Ball at the 29, going quickly back to the ground. Reese with some space, and he'll pick up the first down at the 38.
There you go, Weema, and moving the ball. Don't be scared to run. I mean, there you go, Ziggs. Don't be scared to run the ball.
Yeah.
Right now, the most important thing is putting together a prolific drive and getting yourself a touchdown.
Needs to make it a two-score game. Got to throw it. Finds Reed, and that picks up around 8 yards, second and 2. And
I like the hurry up.
You notice in that LT game, they were very content with swinging it out of the backfield. And right now, Ziggs just out there throwing Stevies.
Yeah, he's got to be more careful with the rock. What could have been? That could have
Gibbs
been.
Would get on me. Gibbs wants me to say Todd's. Throwing some Todd's. Opposite of dots. T-O-D's.
The Todd's. That was a great saying by you and Gibbs. I was actually watching when you guys came up with that. I got support of the Todd's reads.
I can take zero credit for that. Zero.
No.
I think that's all the community that came up with that. Ball to the 40.
Those are Gibbs and Frawls, man. They're pretty witty.
They're in the, yeah, I think it was a member of their community.
Oh, that
started
was,
calling them Todd's.
That's great.
I need the full story.
They got a great community.
Text it in. Text it in to us. We'll give some shout outs here in the booth.
Block shed.
And I tell you what, Billy Weema has had, it's just been one of those things where every bounce has gone his way. Every block shed has gone his way, you know? And sometimes it's like that. And if it continues happening, at some point you got to give credit.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, he's putting his players in position to get these bounces and make things happen. He's playing really good Madden right now. And the way he's even handling this drive is okay, because he's letting Ziggs dink and dunk his way up the field, which is okay as long as you're not giving up the big play, because you want to do exactly what the clock's doing right now. You just want to make sure it continues to tick down.
Finally, he figured it out. Oh. I was wondering if someone was going to figure it out, and it's Cooper.
Cooper with some Fred Flintstone swag right there. On his tippy toes, making it happen. Yabba dabba do.
You know, he's been bringing the heat off that edge with the corner. Nice job motioning Cooper out, getting some space, and it pays off with a touchdown.
Great point. You see the corner coming off of that edge. You know that's one less person in coverage that should be in coverage. Go ahead and attack that area. Attack that blitz inside area. That's a great point, Scott. And he did, and it worked out for him.
So trailing by 13 now. He needs some stops. I can tell you right now, Billy Weema is about to fire up the running game.
He's got to be careful, though. You don't want to become too obvious. You definitely want to try to establish it and run. But you see him passing right here? It's because he doesn't want his opponent to be too keen to exactly what he's doing.
Well, he got eight in the box, too, so you got to get rid of it. And Cooks gets out to the 33, second and two.
Nice read. Nothing too dangerous. Nice little easy drag route. If it wasn't there, he potentially could have ran with Mariota. Really impressed with Weema so far in this tournament.
He's been very conservative, but it works, and he's proven he can take shots when needed. Second and two. 2:47 to go in the third. Leading by 13. Quick. And there is Cooks. And he said it. He said, I can get 2 yards every time. 2 yards, first down.
It's funny because it looked like they blew that play up.
Got nothing.
And he got 2 yards. 2 yards for the first down, just like you said. You got to watch the counter out of this formation right here. He loves the counter out of this weak twin tight.
The first and 10 from the 35. Weema trying to eat up that clock. Quick throw to Cooks. Breaks one. Actually shedded another, too. Finally went down at the 44. Cooks is looking tough.
Yeah, his players are hungry. You usually don't see Cooks breaking tackles like that. But, man, Weema's guys are here to play. What happens when you're a good GM?
We talked about how creative his roster was. You think, I mean, this is the final stop. We've had 8 teams, 8 competitors. So out of 64 players, he has the most creative roster we've seen.
Impressive. It took a while.
Yeah, took us a couple weeks.
Well, I was getting nervous because you were seeing a lot of the same rosters. There's a lot of the same players all over the place. Not a lot of creativity. And then here comes Billy Weema, good old hometown boy from Kansas City, Missouri.
Yeah.
And he puts together the God Squad.
And McFadden has been huge. 12 rushes for 154 yards. But let me caveat, he had 130 on his first 2 carries. Went to the crib twice, and Ziggs was seeing the tilt button.
Okay, though, if he's Ziggy.
No, he just needs to stop. Yeah, he's fine.
There's plenty of time in this game, Scott. If you could just force some sort of big play and get points in a hurry after getting a stop on Weema, pressure's right back on Billy Weems.
Second and 9, ball at the 47, just shy of the 50. Goes back to DMC. He'll pick up a few yards out to the 49 plus territory. Big 3rd and 5 coming up.
This is a big one right here, Scott. I'm really interested to see what type of play calling does Weems have in this situation. If you're Ziggs, you need to watch out from that drag from Cooks. It's been his go-to play out of this formation, especially when he motions that receiver right there. Well, he doesn't have Cooks on the drag. You see the play already. Everyone's going deep. What a play!
Wow, McFadden. That was almost like clear out. It was almost like a quick screen.
This ain't a league of their own, but you could call him Dottie. That was nasty, Scott. I bet the Young Bucks don't get that reference, and even my old heads, absolutely, you better get that one. But that was great. Like you said, the 3 streaks on the right side, clear out the zones, make them go with you, and then McFadden sneaks out of the backfield for the quick hit. Great play calling by Weema. Oh, good hit.
And that'll take us to the fourth quarter. Ball at the 31. In a 13-point game, a field goal would be huge.
For Ziggs, you need to hold them to the field goal because the 2 possessions. It keeps it at a 2-possession ball game. 2-possession ball game with 3 timeouts in the fourth quarter is very doable. A 3-possession ball game, though.
That's a tall task.
You're going to be in some trouble. Come on.
Start of the fourth quarter. Put up your 4s. 5 minutes, one of these guys is punching their ticket to the finals, and right now it's been all Billy Weema.
Here, Ziggy, you got to lay a hit on this McFadden at some point.
And it creeps to the 30. 3rd and 10, and here comes another 25 seconds off the clock.
Yep. And let's see if Weema doesn't make the same mistake that LT made earlier on and hikes the ball a little bit too early. If I'm Weema, I'm taking all of these seconds off of the clock right here.
All your seconds belong to us.
As you see it, six.
Third and 10. Goes to,
Oh, almost a fumble.
So gets to the 18.
And that's huge because that's at the minimum 90 more seconds that he gets to take with him off of the clock stop.
Third and 10, and you give up 12 up the gut.
That's demoralizing. I'd be mad and raging. That's why I don't stream or anything like that. I'd do something like that. Oh, I lose my cool. It's funny. I can talk about everybody. You got to keep your composure and this, that, and the thing, and it all sounds nice. Once I get myself in that situation, composure goes out the window.
So second and 9. Ball at the 17. And Billy Weema just content with chewing up the clock.
What a legend. Coming into Kansas City, defending his turf, fighting off the young buck, fighting off the one seed veteran Warhawk so far. The legend of Billy Weema continues to grow as this event goes on.
And his stick work has gotten much better on the run. It was shaky in that first half against Warhawk.
Super shaky.
But since then, he's settled in. He feels comfortable with being on the stage.
He's definitely getting into a comfort zone right now. And if you're LT or who do we got LT playing? You deserved it. You got to be watching this, preparing. You know, obviously got to be focused for your next game, but in the back of your mind, you better be putting together some sort of strategy to slow down this offense by Billy Weema, because it looks superb right now.
And he'll hand it off to Cooks on the quick sweep.
Wow.
And he'll walk in. There's two things Kansas City does, barbecue and football. Billy Weema looking to go up 20.
Oh, my goodness. Defending his turf. The complete opposite of what happened at Gillette Stadium. Patriots Club Series, for those that don't know. My guy shut it down, walked in, but he was an Eagles fan. Wore a Yankees hat in Massachusetts.
Disrespect.
And walked away with the championship.
Disrespect.
I think Billy Weema saw that happen. He's like, not on my watch, brother. Not happening. Not here in KC.
What a treat for an Eagles fan to get to come to Arrowhead Stadium. It's been a treat for us, but for someone that's so emotionally connected to the club. And what are you thinking if you're Ziggs here? There he is on the left side of your screen. The youngster has not gone the way that you thought the semifinal would go.
He's frustrated. Hopefully this doesn't discourage him, though. At 20 years old.
And a lot of Madden left in your life.
He's got a lot of Madden left in your life. Exactly.
And I know the Ocean Gang boys maybe disappointed how this one's gone thus far, but those guys are a crew that's on the up and coming.
Yeah, and you see Weema in a quarters three deep, man up three deep, just pass coverage defense.
Savage.
And what that's telling his opponents, Scott, is you can take all this underneath stuff, you can run the ball all you want, but I'm not giving up a big play at all. We're going to continue to let this clock tick if you want to move the ball.
Yeah, you're going to have to score 3 touchdowns the rest of the way to beat him.
Yeah. I like the defensive play call by Weema right here. Go ahead and dink and dunk. Go ahead and run the ball. It's fine. Oh, good read.
It has an opening here. There's Jerry Rice trying to cut it back inside. Not going to be able to get another playoff, though, before the 2-minute warning. Ball to 23, trailing by 20.
Allen by 20 with the 2-minute warning. I love it so much better when the games are close, Scott.
Hey, that's not our fault.
It's not our fault.
I mean, Billy Weema has come in here and steamrolled the man from New Jersey. Thought he could come into Kansas City. My man, Billy Weema, says, no, sir. Not having it. And there's a touchdown by Julio. So things get a bit more interesting. The extra point will make this a 13-point game once again, and now Ziggs has to hope for the onside kick.
Yep. Oh, he's gonna kick it. Kick it, play defense.
Gonna have to be returned too by Cooks. Takes it from the 2-yard line.
Get down. Smart right there by Billy Weema. The only way you let Ziggs back in this game is a turnover or something crazy happening. Don't even give them the opportunity to let anything crazy happen. For those at home that are watching that may not be familiar with that mechanic, what Weema did to give up right there and avoid the hit was hold the left trigger, the right trigger, and tap the X button. all at the same time.
And the interesting thing here, I don't even know if he did on purpose, but he fields the kickoff to take more time off the clock. He could have easily hit that bounce through the end zone.
Yeah, he had no opportunity to take a knee, though. The kick was, short. Oh, yeah, no, that's a good point.
But he has the fortitude and the aptitude and the acumen to field it.
Whoa, slow it down with those big
Billy Weema, he's a smart. He took more time off the clock.
There you go.
Yeah, well, shout out to my guys in South Carolina where my hometown is. 34-21. Weema with the rock. Hands it off. And we'll work to the 21. And Ziggs has to use timeout number two. So he needs a stop here.
Yeah, Weema, you kind of want to go after this first down because you get stopped
in the
game.
First down is over.
You end the game instead of you get stopped here. You got to give the ball back to Ziggs. He gets a quick score, recovers an onside kick. Now you're feeling a lot of pressure and you got yourself in a situation you don't want to be in. You can avoid all of that by just getting a first down right here.
Got Paulson in at fullback. McFadden, he'll move Paulson over. They'll put Fitzgerald in the slot, and McFadden holds on to it as Houston had him wrapped up in the backfield. And so with 140, you're going to see the unicorn of Madden. Here comes a punt.
Well, I like you have to punt in this situation because you got to make Ziggs drive down the field, not give up the big play, and continue to take time off of that clock.
Deep punt toward the sideline. Gonna be fielded by Dion. Is it prime time?
He's got room. Ooh.
Just tripped up by Paulson at the 50. But he's working with a relatively short field with 90 seconds to go. Zero timeouts.
This is Madden football, and he's got superstars all over that offense. When I look at it for Oceangangzigs, he's got Jerry Rice, Julio Jones, Amari Cooper, Jordan Reed, Aaron Rodgers, the king of the Hail Mary. He's got the firepower.
And there's the fumble. And it's recovered again by Rodgers. Corner blitz three. This is the defense he's going to bring every down.
A lot of it has been the block sheds from the interior linemen.
They're getting multiple heat.
Yeah, they're bullying those bronze roll linemen out there. And he's just getting a lot of block sheds, causing a lot of havoc.
Billy Weema not feeling comfortable. Calls a timeout on second and 13. Better be safe than sorry.
Yeah, he went to that quarter three deep and then got out of it right away. He said, you know what? I don't want him to just sit back. Oh, he's got him.
Got him.
He's got him.
Julio. Touchdown, Ziggs.
Uh-oh.
And the fat lady hasn't seen yet, my friend.
Not at all. What fat lady are you talking about? And it's onside kick time. If he gets this onside kick, the amount of palm sweat that is probably going to be running through Billy Weema is going to be no joke. This is big, Scott. This
and
is
here's the onside, and it's recovered.
Wow, what a game.
By Weema, and he should be able to take a knee.
Congratulations to Billy Weema.
Ziggs made it.
The hometown hero.
A lot more exciting in the fourth quarter than it should have been. And here's my favorite formation, the victory formation.
We have to give credit to Ziggs.
Oh, yeah.
A young kid.
Battled back.
Who battled back, didn't give up at all, could have got an onside kick and been in position to win the ball game. And that's why you can never give up. It's a game of inches, and one play can often make the difference. You can't take any plays off. You can't give anybody an inch. And you know what? Ziggy showed you why right there. He could have very easily won this game had he recovered that onside kick. If I'm Ziggy, you should be proud of yourself. Don't hang your head down. You came out here. You wanted to show everybody what you're about on the main stage. And one thing you showed us is there's no quit in you, and you're going to fight till the end, and you have the talent to compete on this level. I'm very proud of that young man.
Well, he doesn't have to take another snap. They're just going to run it all the way down. And they're going to talk about it. They're going to say GG's. Got to tip your cap to Weema. Ziggs battled out in that second half, but just got down just a bit too far, RG, before he started creeping back in it. And maybe Weema
got a little conservative down the stretch.
And he did. We saw it with the quarters three deep early at the start of the fourth quarter, end of the third, where he kind of stopped sending pressure and, you know, let Ziggs sit back and make reads and get downfield and get a touchdown, which, you know, it almost cost him. But at the end, he was able to make plays when he needed to, and he did enough to win the game. When you're up by three scores, I mean, you obviously did a lot, right? Like, you were getting it done.
Yeah. I mean, twice, he was up by 20. Had 20-point leads twice, and the game ended in a six-point differential.
Yeah, that was a phenomenal game. I'm a fan of both of those players. I'm a Billy Weema fan, and I'm a Ziggy fan going forward. I hope to get to see a lot more of those guys as these competitive Madden eSport events continue to happen.
Well, it hasn't struck midnight yet for our Cinderella. The local guy is standing by with our man, Pete Sweeney.
Thanks, Scott. And here I am with the local hero, Billy Weema, headed to the finals. You came in as an 8 seed. Here you are, a finalist. How have you done it so far?
That game just got up early, and I kind of played a little conservative, but I had the lead to build with. So, you know, got a little closer than I thought. I had to sweat out an onside, but, I mean, it was a good game.
When he gets in within a score like that, what's going through your head?
You just got to field the onside, and the game's over. But you always got to sweat that out because sometimes they get them.
Now, you had the first two games. They went your way. This means a lot more. This means California, the next level. How do you prepare for this game?
Just try to do the same thing I've been doing. I mean, it's working so far, so don't try to overhype it too much and just play my game.
All right, well, Billy Weema, the only Chiefs fan headed in this tournament, is trying to head to California wearing a Chiefs jersey. We'll see if it can happen. Right now, we're going to go to highlights, and it's back to you, Scott.
All right, thanks so much, Pete Sweeney.